No, this is not my first job.
What's up, everyone? This is going to be the first of our two breaks tonight. This will be, we're going to do the 2015 Bowman draft and best first, and then we're going to do the half case, which is a mistake on my part that we're even doing both of them on the same night. Appreciate everyone who joined.
To me, is the contending teams like in today's NBA, the Golden State Warriors have They have four offenses. Even Cavaliers have three. They even have a couple of MVP candidates like Kawhi Leonard being their team, and Isaiah Thomas being their team. And then there's kind of everybody that's trying to figure it out. Toronto has two All-Stars. So who's the second best player on the Pacers is always my question. Is it going to be Miles Turner? Is it going to be Thad Young? Jim Robinson III is showing flashes. Also at the point, team is getting the points and getting the assists. I think when they get that second player that they can consistently rely on, it allows Paul to be that all-star level performer. All
right.
And then it unlocks the rest of the opportunities for the guys in the field.
So here is tonight's products. We got a hobby box of each. So we got a hobby box of 2015 Bowman draft and a hobby box of 2015 Bowman's best. So let's start with the draft. Gonna go quicker tonight than I usually go, because we got both of these breaks to do. So, anyone interested in unsold teams, speak now or forever hold your peace. Oh, we got a box topper. We have a box topper. First one I have gotten of these. Box topper. Look at that. I'll save that for the very end of this break. That will go to whoever team, whoever owns the team of the player on the box topper. So, might be autographed, might not be. Who knows? Peter Funkin, Box Topper. So, here we go.
I'm going off emotion, and I felt like that's just how I felt. You know, I talked to Brad about it. And I got to do a better job in those situations, but at the same time, I'm going to speak my mind, especially with being a leader on this team. I'm not going to throw anybody under the bus. That's not who I am. I made sure Brad knew I wasn't throwing him under the bus. That's just how I felt at that point in time. And I want what's best for this team. And I know by being a leader and that guy, when I say things, they're going to get blown out of proportion, especially when we lose a few in a row. If we would have won and I said that, it wouldn't even been a problem. And I understand that. So I'll do a better job and I'll continue to get better at those things.
So that's a bit of a backtracking from the original statement. But I want to hear your reaction to when you initially.
What's up, Brewer? Brewer, you gotta be watching on the Ustream. I almost didn't do it on YouTube today.
I mean, a couple years ago, Isaiah was a backup, and a very good one.
Kirby and Supac Chrome.
I was down for 30 points a game, and you got a great young coach that's really running all of the plays to him. So I initially didn't like it, but obviously I know being at Lockhorn after a tough game, you lose, you know, you're emotional, you say things that I was proud that he, you know, he owned my effort and he was right.
He'll get a pass for this, and rightfully so, because he was speaking out of emotion. It was after a tough loss on the road.
We got a factor of Josh Stelmark, the Red Chrome.
And you're the outright leading scorer every night.
Right.
That's a lot of pressure. So much so, a player that really hasn't done that before, 2006. That was Kobe Bryant. So, for Isaiah,
Kyle Tucker paper,
like I said, for Indiana, as a guy that he can now rely on to make shots, take shots, take some pressure off of him, allow him to actually give him attention to the defense, everything we thought that would be Albert.
We did think that would be
Albert. Yeah, he's getting assists, but I need to see more rebounds. I need to see more points out of him because he's a former All-Star as well.
That thing is Eddie Bradley. I really do. I mean, he missed up for, you know, a nice portion of the season, but he's a guy that, you know, not only is he a great defensive player, but he's...
Yeah, man, the quality on Ustream is much better.
He's all over the place.
The screen itself, plus the camera.
I really love all the screens. This is especially in particular down the stretch. Guy makes winning plays. He's giving you a championship.
We got a refactor of... Justin Jacoby.
I mean, you watched them last week, I think, against Cleveland, and some of those ancillary pieces right there made shots and plays late in the game for them to beat the Cavaliers. So there's some pieces there, but I agree with you. They need somebody to step up there.
And really, it's kind of hockey. They're number two seed in the Eastern Conference. They held on to the
Max Wilkow Chrome. We got draft night of Garrett Whitley.
Is what I love about teams.
Really, Dallas come
back in the locker room, and you look at Avery Bradley and Marcus Smart, you say, man, I appreciate you guys guarding my man every night. Thank you kindly, Jay Crowder on that final switch. Hey, Jay LeBron, you got to be ready tonight when I get stuck on stress, and I get stuck on stress. So that gives you that humility to go to the coach.
Yeah, light blue of Brett Lilick, however you want to pronounce it, who are Julius Chrome.
Emotion was the key word. They were up and ended up losing. They lost two straight. And now, they're going to win. It's just glorious. What do you have to want from them?
I can just remember, you know, there's been some very, very good Celtics Warriors games over the last few years.
Yeah, they've been there last year.
And they've been very, very good. You're talking about excellent guard play.
Mm-hmm.
One of the things I'm really...
Josh Miller, Chrome.
This guy wants that third.
Alex Bandino.
You know,
draft dividends. AJ Reed, Chrome.
He plays Steph Curry pretty well, Zayn. So, you know, Steph is, you know, without KD, he's going to look out of use of the score that I mentioned.
When the Warriors are playing at home against good teams, I think the Splash Brothers...
Kyle Holder, Chrome. Chris Betts, refractor for the ladies.
Where you get better play from Iguodala and from Livingston. If you deal with me a couple of dunks, so I have an opportunity to make a couple of plays. In particular, Draymond Green, however. Because he's going to feed off the home crowd. He's going to be undersized up front like he is every night. But he is charged to not only be there both emotionally, but also he's just seeing the rebounding and assists from this guy.
Just so we're aware, the Spurs drafted Marcus Aldridge and Kawhi Leonard tonight. And we talked before the game about how Steve Kerr was, you know, basically struggling with the idea of whether
or not Austin Riley Chrome.
Number one spot. How much?
Roman Collins Chrome.
I pay attention. No, I think there's a lot of value in having a number 14 and having a possible game 7 at home. But, you know, I guess Coach Pop is the best coach that you know, maybe ever in basketball, saying, I don't really care where we're at. Just get me there.
But also, he was a guy doing that with
a factor of
the final. Players
were
playing international.
David Fletcher.
He was actually doing that to preserve his players.
Cody Jones, Chrome.
Four long playoff runs.
Spencer Adams, Zuma, Robertson.
I have a lot of these teams, but you know what? I ain't gonna take the wrong answer. So that's why there has to be some level of, you know, top player, top team, you deserve it. Okay, you get a night off, But other than that, I'd rather see guys get fined or something.
You want like a regulated, almost like a chart?
No, fans always sit there on the road. I don't want to keep them home fans and have them on Saturday. I don't know. And you don't want to play part of the game that mess up your stats.
We got Mikey White Chrome. We got a Ash Russell. Ash Russell draft dividends.
Alright, so you expect
Raphael Devers Chrome.
I think this is Steph's night to say, what about me? I'll be
the
MVP last year.
Ooh, we got a nice hit for the D-backs here. Dansby Swanson, light blue refractor. Also had a Ryan Burr Chrome there.
And that was a big deal. That is a big deal for him.
Tip off
Celtics and Warriors.
Nice card there for the D-backs. Centering is off a little bit, but... Hey, still a nice card.
J.A., sorry about Northwestern. Keep him in line, Jonesy.
The NBA on ESPN is presented all season long by State Farm, here to help life go right, and in part by Honda.
All right, that was the first half of Bowman Draft. Half number two. Devin Tate, Chrome for the Rangers. A Kevin Duchesne refractor for the A's. We got a die cut for the Marlins, Josh Miller and Avery Romero. Hunter Renfro Chrome for the Padres. Jeff Degano Chrome, Kevin Kramer Refractor, we've got a blue paper parallel here. We got Austin Ray Chrome. And for the Braves, Austin Riley, blue paper parallel. Nice card. Numbered out of 150. It's number 125 out of 150.
The Microsoft Cloud turns information into insight.
David Dahl Chrome.
My sweat defense gives me 48 hours for protection. Two, gorillas have strong muscles and do not speak English.
These people are real
people, chicken sandwiches. The meat is very juicy, very tasty. I don't remember where they came from, chicken sandwiches, but
they're good. They go to the new, they get into it. They go on, they go to the 60 and they go out, all the other kids.
Alright, welcome to NBA Wednesday, presented by State Farm.
Ash Russell Chrome.
Celtics rolling into the Bay Area, where many here believe
Michael Chavis Chrome.
After the NBA Championship still run through Oakland and Oracle Arena. The home team back at the bridge. The first time in 8 games. They play 5 games away from home. The first about 8,000 miles. Steph Curry.
Carson Fulmer, Brendan Rodgers as a paper, We got Lance James Caprillion, Bowman Scouts Fantasy Impact, Austin Meadows Chrome.
They lost two games in a row for the first time in almost 2 years. They lost Kevin Durant, their leading scorer, Steph Curry, the two-time MVP, went to an unprecedented Phoenix loss. And despite all that hard, they're the clear favorite to win it all, particularly if Durant gets back to even approximating full strength. Curry's had an underrated year. There's been so much other MVP talk, but he's had
a Michael Soroka Chrome.
Well, Thomas is right.
We got a Juan Lopez Bowman Scouts Fantasy Impact.
60th pick in the draft to now an MVP candidate, averaging
Justin Giacomi Chrome.
Joining Green and Julia in the front court, the Splash Brothers lining up in the back court for the Golden State Warriors.
Right. Trey Supak, Refractor.
Underway, hurry up.
Roman Quinn Chrome. Down to our final three packs here. We got Kramer. Ooh, we got an orange refractor autograph for the Cubbies of Donnie DeWeese. Donnie DeWeese orange refractor auto. That's a big pull. Cubbies paid off in this one. Hope they pay off in the half caser too. That is a big hit. Centered very nicely, in my opinion, which is far from expert.
We talk all the time about Golden State's
Get
more
ease toppers. Damn, a box topper and an orange refractor auto.
They're a dominant team. That's what you do. You're great at both ends.
They're what a beautiful card.
It's been that way for quite some time now. Julia working from the elbow, Curry.
Finish off that pack. Got a Garrett Whitley Chrome. Couple of papers. We got a JP Crawford refractor. Courtney Hawkins Chrome.
You have to focus your game on
got a purple refractor for the Cardinals of Jake Woodford. Seeing number 201 out of 250. We got Cole Stewart Chrome, and that'll do it for our Bowman Draft Box. Oh, the numbering on the Donnie DeWeese is 21 out of 25, if anyone wanted to know.
Fourth game now,
without
Kevin Durant.
Yeah, definitely a nice hit.
Back out to Thompson with the floater, and knocks down the first bucket of the ball game. Clay Thompson coming off a 13 points game, 5 of 12 against the Hawks a couple nights ago. Bradley lost the handle.
Alright. Give me one sec. Sort these for a recap.
Textbook jump shot in transition. The Celtics, though, three straight turnovers to start the game. We've got a little over a month to go in the regular season, and that was Klay Thompson's 200th three-point field goal. Well, they switched the handoff. Green with great hands. And then Curry with the hard push
And that's a ridiculously hard shot on the run that Klay Thompson looks, makes it look absolutely effortless.
Thompson shooting 41% from downtown of the season of Horford.
All right.
Thompson with the board.
That stuff is ready. We'll save that box topper until after the Bowman's Best box.
What's how tricky is that? Well, the NBA would say that's a quirk in scheduling. I would say you need a better computer. Green missed the slam, looked for the foul. And Bradley shows him how it's
all right, Bowman's Best.
And you think about it, they're out for five. They come back for
2015.
And then fly to Minnesota and play back-to-back in San Antonio. And Boston has a ridiculous schedule, too. They're going to Denver. And then 26 hours later, they're playing at home at 3:30 in the afternoon on Sunday.
Well, Bradley was strong off the backboard. Remember, Golden State with a huge day coming up against San Antonio, 7-9 on ABC. Very in traffic.
2015, Bowman's Best.
And it's just with the basketball return on the shot clock.
Ready box number one.
Thompson blows by Horford. Great feat. Here with the sauce. Klay Thompson. It's 3-5 out of the game quickly from all seven Warriors.
Horford looks for Watson to shoot the 3-point so far.
Wonder how much that has to do with his elbow injury.
We got a mirror image of Corey Seager and Trey Kulowitzki. Anthony Rizzo, the factor. Alright, so we got Kulowitzki are the odd numbers. Corey Seager is the even numbers. So Toronto, odd. LA, even. If I can find the guy. Alright, let's give a little bird's eye view for Chris.
Great, excellent effort in transition. And a nice find by Green.
We got 20.
And clearly.
That's going with Seager and the Dodgers.
On the 3-point attempt. And the two-time All-Defensive First Team member is Curry knocks down the first free throw. Seth Curry shooting 91% from the free throw line. And the first time in his career, he made a low point with respect to his 3-point shooting in 3 consecutive games. But for him, a slump is defined a little bit differently.
You good?
He's dipped under 40% from the 3-point
line. All right, going to the Dodgers.
Struggling, you're shooting the 39. As many attempts as he's taken, it's okay.
We got a high def heritage for the Nationals, Lucas Giolito, not autographed. Cincinnati Reds, we got an Alex Blandino autograph. Base auto, Alex Blandino. Chichi Gonzalez, rookie refractor for the Rangers.
Just another variation of the flop. You see, every team is perfecting this acting job.
Tough game to officiate. As Thomas knocks down the first, Isaiah Thomas, the
you were alluding to it a little bit earlier, folks, when you talked about his career arc. You think that to the fact that he started last season as a reserve throughout the bench.
We got Felix Hernandez. We're going to have to random this one off. We got Brendan Rodgers for the Rockies and Xander Bogaerts for the Red Sox. Alex Reyes refractor, Buster Posey, and Tyler Kolek. So we're going to have Bogaerts be the odd numbers, Rodgers even. So Red Sox are odd, Rockies are even. All right, and it's a 15. That's going to be odd for the Red Sox.
These are a couple of teams that are amongst the league leaders in 3.2 field attempts per game. As I'm Crowder gets a two inside on the nice dive from Al Horford. And Al Horford's their second leading assist man. His
Clayton Kershaw, first impressions Carson Fulmer, Byron Buxton with Rodney Rivey, Anthony Rendon, and Luis Severino. And our final autograph for the Blue Jays, Max Pentecost. For the Blue Jays. I shouldn't say our last autograph, our second autograph. In that mini box. We've still got a whole other mini box. Remainder of the pack, Mike Trout, Jock Peterson, the refractor rookie, Pineda, and Glass now.
So you don't know what
they
would
offer
and what they could have done. It's just saying
This team break. Two box team break sold through eBay. Oh, what do you know, Seattle? Kyle Seager Superfractor. Holy shnikes. Kyle Seager Superfractor numbered 1/1. I haven't pulled a Superfractor in like 2 years. Holy crap. That is a big time hit for the Mariners. Wow. Wow. I am going to grab a stand. I almost brought this over here before. I had a feeling we were going to hit something big, and we've hit two monster cards tonight. I'm just going to leave that right there. That is beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. We have Dodgers and Dodgers, Urias and Kershaw, so no need to random. Tyler J and Tyler Stevenson. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. We got a Julio Urias High Def Heritage, non-autograph.
Oh, no. What? Oh, hi, Sarah.
I thought you.
No, I'm okay. He's a sketch, though.
All right. Carlos Rodon. And for the Cardinals, Nick Plummer autograph. Nick Plummer for the St. Louis Cardinals. I believe that's going to Brewer, Scott Brewer.
While seated in a chair. Other than that, he says he's just chilling and watching movies. Remember, the
Warriors... That's the Rat Pack, Archie Bradley, refractor rookie, Raul Mondesi. You got Michael Franco, rookie card, D. Gordon, Brewers and Dodgers this time. Brewers and Dodgers, Ryan Braun, Jack Peterson, A.J. Cole, and Todd Frazier. So, Brewers are going to be the odd numbers, Dodgers will be the even numbers. We got odd, that's going to the Brewers. Going to the Brew Crew. We got a Carlos Gomez, Atomic Refractor, Trent Clark Refractor, Chris Sale, and Austin Meadows. And with our last autograph for the break, for this break, our last pack, we have, it's a nice one, Mariano Rivera Jr. for Washington Nationals, Atomic Refractor, numbered out of 50. Mariano Rivera. That is a nice looking card. Oh, not Jr., Mariano Rivera the third. Sorry about that. Last but not least, we got our box topper to open still. And the rest of this pack is Blackman, Donaldson Refractor, Meyer, and Devers. We still have our box topper from the Bowman Draft box to open. Too bad that wasn't a Corey Seager. Box topper. I'm feeling a Kyle Tucker. Feeling a Kyle Tucker non-autograph, but we'll see. Oh, even better. Let's see if there's ink on it, though. This is the best box topper you can get in this product. I'll tell you that right now. So, with that being said, I think most of us will know it's Andrew Benintendi. Now, does it have ink on the front? It does not. Still, gorgeous box topper for the Red Sox. I was going to say, there were no Benintendis in this. That is numbered out of 50. I don't know if that's the base or if that's some sort of parallel, because I've never pulled one of these, but that is the box topper. So we will do a quick recap after I save this.